You don't think this is going to trial now, do you? Last night's fire is clearly the work of the same person who started the other two fires. Now, we know for a fact that Warren was nowhere near the Henderson place when it went up, and he has alibis for the other two. So let's face it, we've got the wrong man.
We found it right where Grant Carlton said it would be, and what's the best of Carl's fingerprints all over it?
Excellent. I think I'm going to pay young Mr. Henderson a visit.
Look, you've no reason to keep hassling my brother like this.
Well, don't mind, this won't take long. Carl Henderson, I'm arresting you on suspicion of theft of a vehicle, failing to stop at the scene of an accident and the assault on Rod Jessup.
Well, don't be stupid, mate, it's just a kid.
In your defence, if you do not mention when questioned something that you later rely on in court, anything you do say may be given in evidence.
It was an accident.
Shut your mouth, Carl. Come on, I'm going to get your scissor.
All I was doing was going for a spin. I didn't know I was going to see Jessup. When I did, I thought I'd frighten him. I drove past the school. I see him about to cross the road. So I bid to him. And then I thought, well, I'd have a laugh and teach him a lesson for everything that happened yesterday. So I turned round. I revved up the engine and drove towards him. I only meant to scare him. I was going to swerve at the last minute. I lost control. I hit him. Honestly, I promise. I really, really didn't want to hurt him.
Like your brother said, you better get yourself a solicitor. The best one your money can buy you. Come on.
It fitted the profile.
No, you made it fit. I've listened to the tapes. And it's pretty damn obvious you had no interest in proving his innocence, only his guilt.
If the kid had told the truth, I could have eliminated from our inquiries from the word go. Now, as it is, the CPS clearly felt that there was enough to move this case forward, so I don't understand why you're busting my chops about it.
Passing the buck to the CPS is not good enough. It's a copper's duty to find the truth, and I expect my team to respect that. Is that clear? Sorry, I didn't hear that.
Yes, Gov.
Right, can you send DS Nixon in?
Gov. Look, I'm not going to make any excuses. We completely screwed up that arson investigation. And it isn't entirely Stuart's fault. I'm to blame as well.
Well, I'm not happy about it. I mean, this morning we had avenues to explore and now we have none. I need a result. You've shown the level of tenacity and objectivity that I'd expect of you in a case like this. And that's why you've got the job. You pleased him. I mean, it's quite a result, isn't it, considering you weren't even going to apply this morning?
Well, it's a good thing I've got a boss who's shown me the error of my ways.
Right, well, we'll announce it after we've notified the other candidates. Congratulations, D.I. Nixon.
Thanks, Gov.
Well, we've arrested Kyle. He'll be charged as soon as he leaves the hospital. I thought I was going to lose you, you know.
No such luck. Hey.
Sorry.
Why don't you go home and get some sleep? Go on, you can deal with it. I'll still be here tomorrow.
No, I've been thinking about what you said.
What did I say? It was something stupid. It's down to the drugs.
Now, a few days ago, when you sort of asked me to marry you.
Oh, that was stupid. No excuses for it either.
Well, I'd sort of like to say yes. If you still have me.
Yes. Yes, of course.
We're going to have an in-depth review of each case file, and we're going to revisit the scene of each fire.
Yeah, we can re-interview some of the witnesses. I've started pulling the files.
We're also going to set up a new series of door-to-doors. And if that doesn't throw up another lead, then we go back to the beginning and we start again. There's an arsonist on the loose in Sun Hill, and it's only a matter of time before he strikes again.
Yeah, they're getting better at it too. Getting a real thirst for it, Gov.
So let's catch him before somebody dies.